Hello. I am coming to you with a another sports card show pickup video. I'm shooting this on September 22nd, 2018, which is a Saturday, and earlier today I went to a Sports Cards of Houston show out in Katy, which is a little west of Houston, about 25 miles from where I live. I picked up almost 200 cards and three boxes that I guess I can say they're from the junk wax era. Bought all this for I think it was $50. Pretty good deal, I think. The backdrop is of Orbit, the Astros mascot. The one on the left is a can't get him to move, but to move it the way I want him to. It's described as a bobble belly. His midsection moves instead of his head. He's kind of big around the midsection, and the one in the middle is from, I don't know, 3-4 years ago from the Star Wars day. The Astros had Orbit One Kenobi, and then some little got. I think I got the left in the middle at the Astros game, and then at two different Astros games, and then the one on the right is, I think I got that at a card store. Not sure though. Anyway, and for those of you who watch my pickup and haul videos on a regular basis, know I like to give y'all something else to listen to besides my voice. And today for this video, and I think I probably do at least two videos, maybe three, definitely two. For these pickup card sports card videos, is the score to the first Mission Impossible movie, which I think came out in 1996, done by Danny Elfman. I like Danny Elfman's work. Kind of quiet music right now, but it'll pick up. What I'm going to do is do the 50 cent cards first, I guess, along with the boxes, and then after that, the other video will be all the 10 cent cards I got. The vast majority of cards are 10 cent cards. Anyway, I got the 50 cent cards. Most were baseball and some were football. And the 10 cent, all baseball. 50 cent, like I said, baseball and football. Anyway, start with Astros. This is a Topps Chrome Yuri Gurriel. Got some nice shine. Sorry about the glare from the sleeve. Keep on going, and another Yuri Gurriel, some Topps release. Now, I'm going to try not to worry about what year they came out of, because it'll just prolong the video, and insert Jose Altuve insert from Topps. Well, of course, I guess they're pretty much all Topps, because they own the exclusive license, at least when it comes to the MLB. I guess no other companies have Players Association. Anyway, here's National Baseball Card Day 2018 of Jose Altuve. Got a Alex Bregman, Allen and Ginter from 2018. Says, well, that goes against what I just said, but I said that because the year's on the front of the card. Now we got a Marwin Gonzalez Topps Chrome. That's nice shine along with the glare. And last Astro is Derek Fisher. And I got the Astros on in the background. It's 1-0 Astros in the top of the 8th. Verlander started. He pitched another great game. Anyways, keep on going. Got, I'm not even sure, some Topps card, Bo Jackson. Early 80s. Carlton Fisk, Topps All-Star card. Oops, sorry. Kind of out of frame. Dodgers Hall of Fame Heroes card of Mickey Mantle from, I guess, the early 80s. Too bad it's not a one from the 50s, but anyway. Dodgers Diamond Kings Cal Ripken Jr. These are just some of the random cards I got that, I don't have at least two of them. Two of a certain player. Anyways, keep on going. Roger Clemens, Fleer from the early, mid-80s. Scratch that. Yes, yeah. Dungeons, Diamond Kings, Tom Seaver, I guess early 80s. I'm guessing from the 1973, talking about the night for the 1972 World Series, Reds win squeaker. I guess was to say game three of the series. And this one, remember, I paid 50 cents for Kirby Puckett Fleer rookie card from the 85. Looked it up and at books, and I know a lot of people don't put a lot of stock, neither do I, in the book value. But it goes up to $20. It's in pretty good condition. What the? I think someone might have trimmed it. Son of a biscuit, look at that. I don't know if y'all can order one of it as a printing flaw. Right there, upper right hand corner. Maybe that's why he's only selling it for 50 cents. Anyway, I guess 50 cents, I can't complain too much. Anyway, at least I have a Kirby Puckett rookie card. Anyways, keep on going. Anyway, from 1980, RBI leaders from each league featuring Dave Winfield and Don Baylor. Oh, nuts. There's a runner on second with no outs. Keep this win for Verlander, please, Astros. Here's a, I guess, from the early 80s, Dave Winfield. Now we're getting to the cards that have at least two or more for a particular player. Here's a Fleer 92 Fleer All-Star Barry Bonds insert card. And I guess some Topps Black Gold, probably from the mid-90s, Barry Bonds. Making contact with the ball. And from 1980, has the 1979 strikeout leaders, J.R. Richard and Nolan Ryan. Okay, so I guess that the other cards weren't my... That one card wasn't my last Astros card. This is half an Astros card. That was half right. Oh, damn it. Another double. Well, there goes Verlander's win. Now we get a nose sitter. Decision. Here's another one. It has Nolan Ryan in Astros uniform from the 82 Dunners. But I don't put Nolan Ryan with the Astros, even when he's with his in an Astros uniform. I always put him in his own section. Fleer, I guess early 80s Fleer, Mike Schmidt. I'm pretty sure I don't have that card of him. Dunder's Diamond Kings, I guess from the early 80s, featuring Schmidt. Holy Schmidt! And a bad joke, people. I'm here all week. Early 80s, I guess Fleer, Fountain of Youth, featuring Willie Stargell and Pete Rose. Oops, sorry about the glare. Probably, I think, from the same year and set, Pete Rose. Pretty sure I don't have that one. I guess, what, 80, mid-80s Tops? Ozzie Smith. And I guess a little bit earlier in the decade, featuring Ozzie Smith in a Padres uniform. The Wizard, best fielding shortstop of all time, I think. Now we got, I guess, mid-80s Fleer, featuring Tony Gwynn. And I guess another mid-80s. I think a year after the previous Fleer featuring Tony Gwynn. Okay, and last baseball, 50 cent baseball card from 1990 Leaf, Tony Gwynn. You're a Padres fan. Now it's on to the football cards. I paid 50 cents for each. The one Oiler card is of Archie Manning in a Oilers uniform. And only got, I guess only three Texans cards. Dodgers Optic, DeAndre Hopkins. Another Dodgers Optic, I guess a different year featuring DeAndre. And a Select featuring Will Fuller. He had a touchdown last game against the Titans, which the Texans should have won. It was a nice long pass from Deshaun Watson. Now it's on to some other cards. Let's see, Bears from the 1981 Tops, I guess. Bears team leaders. And let's see, from 1978, I guess. 1977 punting leaders featuring Ray Guy and Tom Blanchard. Now we have, let's see if we got them all together. Yeah, okay, I got some Brett Favre cards. Ultra. Some decent shine towards the bottom where his name is. Pinnacle, I guess an insert. Instincts. Sometimes it serves you well, sometimes they don't, those instincts. Select, I guess I'm gonna insert card from select. And last Brett Favre card, Topps Finest, I guess maybe an insert, I don't know. Now, it's on the last three baseball card, football cards, sorry, are of Tom Brady, Elite. Topps card, I think, some insert. And last one, Panini Contenders from 2014. Okie dokie. Let's see. Now, the three boxes. I got two baseball, one football from the Junk Wax era. The first one is 1992 Score Baseball Series 2. Wrapped still, it's 1992 Upper Deck Baseball. Find the Williams. Wouldn't it be great if I got a Ted Williams autograph? I doubt it. But. And the football, 1992 Fleer. There's only one series for this one. And in the mail, a little side note, in the mail I got my newest issue of Beckett Magazine, Beckett Baseball. Bryce Guy, I like flipping through these. Got a subscription. I think I got about 7 issues left. Anyway, that's all for this one. I guess part 2 will be, hopefully it'll only be one more video. See if I can, because I think the 10 cent cards number around 154. So I have to go through those really fast. Anyway, if you liked what you saw here, please hit like, subscribe, the little notification bell, so on and so forth. Till next time, thank you for watching.